Yennefer's suspicions proved true. Ciri had appeared in Skellige. She'd arrived from another world together with a masked mage. She and the mage had fought the Wild Hunt before fleeing through portals that carried them to Velen. There, one trail ended, another began. A good time later, the Wild Hunt had reappeared on Hindersfjall, meaning Ciri, too, might have returned to Skellige.
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is TrophyNut, and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Dead March difficulty. Today, I'm going to continue the main quest and enter Lofoten alongside Yennefer to see where on the island of Hindersfjall, where we currently are, the Wild Hunt actually struck. But by the looks of it, it was really right here. So let's see what happened here.
Ritual of some kind. We'll have to wait.
We'll do no such thing.
And there's a trophy.
Dear sisters, pardon the interruption, but we've an important matter to discuss.
Can you not see we're commemorating the dead? So?
And we're looking for someone who's still alive. Please, this is urgent. Then speak.
So the trophy must have been for discovering a certain number of landmarks. So there you go, trophy. So, they say the Wild Hunt destroyed your village.
They say the Wild Hunt destroyed this village.
And then there was
that
silence.
That's true. Though few believe us. You don't either, I'm sure. Did you see riders on skeletal horses, wearing frost-covered armor?
Aye, that's how it was. They landed on our shores in a ship made of the claws of dead men, like in the ballads. Leif yelled to grab the children. Then they came, cut him across his face. He tried to whisper, only blood came out.
You were to ask about someone, not prod their wounds. That's enough. What happened then?
Well, Yennefer is not one to listen.
Go on.
I ran out to get help, to get Leif. But so many bodies. Jolle, Ingvar, little Neggy.
Which way did the riders go?
Towards the sea. Through the ravine, on horses made of bones. Bones and ice and...
Enough! Get to the point. Now.
Okay.
We're looking for Ciri. A young woman, name of Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes.
I'm sorry. She is not here.
Unless she lies in a grave. That is, I do not recall one by that name. But I've buried so many, I may have forgotten.
This Ciri... Has she a scar here on her cheek?
Yes. Yes, what happened to her?
Don't know. Saw her but for a moment, right before it all. She was in the stables with Craven. 1,000 curses upon him.
Okay, and what was she doing there?
Remember anything else? Anything at all?
Only that she seemed tired. Very tired. And her hair was wet.
Great. So we know she bathed. Progress.
I'm sorry, Craven. My apologies, Craven. Craven could have told you more.
What was that other name she wanted to use?
This Craven you mentioned, does he have a name?
He did. Until the elders struck him from the saga of ancestors.
Oh.
It's as if he has ceased to exist. The lore forbids anyone from touching him, speaking to him, even uttering his name.
What did he do to deserve that?
He fled from the Wild Hunt. He alone.
We need to talk to him, even if it's not in keeping with your customs.
You've come too late. He went to the garden to fight Morkvarg.
Morkvarg. If he ran away from the Wild Hunt, why would he go and fight some monsters?
A coward who willingly seeks battle? Am I the only one who sees the contradiction?
That's why he did it. Craven knew he would prove the elders wrong only if he killed Morkvarg.
And thus regain his honor and his name.
Trial by ordeal. Very Skellige.
I do not mock your laws. Please also respect ours.
We do. So, what the hell is a Morkvarg?
Morkvarg. What's that?
Who, you mean?
The vilest man ever to inhabit Skellige. Nothing was ever sacred to him. He attacked his own clan's lands, took gold from Nilfgaard, killed children, pregnant women.
Sounds like a real asshole.
They said he feared only one thing, the wrath of the gods. Lokvarg sought to prove how wrong they were, so he sailed to Hindisfjall to ransack the goddess's garden. This was over a decade ago.
Archpriestess Ulva stood in his way. He thrust a blade between her ribs and cast her down in the mud. As her lifeblood left her, she cursed him, and Morkvarg transformed into a beast.
A curse? A monster? You've got some work to do.
Well, I hope you're going to help me. But hey.
I can get rid of Morkvarg. Don't know what he's turned into, but a silver sword should do the trick.
It's not that simple. There have been those who have bested Morkvarg, yet he always returns.
That sounds like a problem.
Meaning I need more information.
I understand, but I've told you all I know.
Speak with Toradar's son, Einar. He was in the garden when Morkvarg and his men attacked. He saw what happened. Of all the pilgrims there at the time, he alone escaped with his life. He settled in Larvik. You'll find him there at the landing, provided he's not out to sea when you arrive.
Okay, that's a lead at least. Where is this holy garden?
Not far from here. North. We cultivated healing herbs there once.
And now?
Now we walk only as far as the tree the goddess planted. We place our offerings and make our pleas before it.
Those who venture below remain in the garden forever.
Because of Morgvark, probably. So, thank you ladies for your help.
Thanks for your help.
I think we have enough information.
I intend to enter the garden. I dislike it when foreigners enter the sacred grounds. But so be it.
Custom demands pilgrims make an offering of their own blood before the tree. Craven surely did so. Unless he lacked not only courage, but respect for Freyr as well.
You needn't worry about us. Geralt and I always give the gods the respect they are due.
We do? That's the first thing I've heard about that. So, missing persons. Find Freya's garden and look for Craven. I thought we needed to talk to someone first. So yeah, there's also the In Wolf's Clothing quest. So I'm gonna first talk to this Einar character about the curse.
Worried this trail might have gone cold.
Even if Craven's dead, we'll manage.
How exactly?
We'll see when the time comes.
You could stand to be nicer sometimes.
I suppose. But then I wouldn't be the woman you fell in love with, would I?
Touché. So Einar is over that way, so I'm wondering what will happen if I just abandon Yennefer for a bit. Nothing bad, I presume. So see you at Einar's place in a second. So at the landing, as the woman told us, where we might find this Einar character, I think.
Oh, as strong as he looks.
That's him. Hello.
You're a you, dimwit. Drop one more and I'll keelhaul you.
Got a minute?
Preparing my boat, can't you see? Nilfgaardian dogs were the hunter's son.
Got bigger game in mind. Morkvarg.
Ah, so them's your apples. All right, ask away. In praise of Freya.
Okay, that's really casual the way he talks about that beast, but what happened there?
You were there when Morkvarg raided the garden. Heard you alone survived.
True. I managed to flee. Great Mother was looking out for me that day.
Good for you.
Bet she didn't give a lick about the priestesses.
Apparently. Morkvarg had them bound, then slit their throats like horses for the sacrifice. And he laughed. Understand? He laughed.
Okay then.
But Archpriestess Ulver cursed him with her dying breath. You are beastly now, remain so forevermore. Ah, saintly woman.
Okay then. Why didn't you help the priestesses?
Didn't help the priestesses. Why not?
How could I? Alone against a dozen raiders.
Oh, Morkvarg wasn't alone.
Staring.
We didn't know that.
Just wondering. You people, obsessed with honor, courage, and so on. But you just cut and run? Strange.
Ooh.
I ain't proud of it.
Don't want to step on any toes here.
Since that day, I've been seeking a worthy death at sea.
No, I don't want to.
Seems the goddess, she's not seen fit to summon me yet.
Okay, then, and what happened to Mork Varg?
What happened to Mork Varg?
Hard to believe, but fur rose through his skin, and his mug stretched forth into a muzzle like a dog's or a wolf's. He howled, long and grieving, then lunged at his men.
It sounds like a werewolf.
They tried to run, but he was fast as lightning. As he
it's really interesting them, that it happened immediately. Throats,
they turned to ash, just like that. Ash that seeps from twixt his fangs.
Not good. Curse must be complex, multi-leveled.
Such is the Great Mother's power.
Okay then. Well, it didn't save her life, but thanks for the information.
Thanks for your help.
Goddess, guide your sword.
Goodbye, Einar. So let's head back to Yennefer before she's mad at us. So see you back there in a second. So she's not standing here anymore, but I'm supposing she went to the garden but on her own. There we go. Ah, there she is. Hello, Yennefer.
A bite. Just one morsel. One piece. A crumb. Food. Food.
There's Mork Varg.
Shank! Not again! Not again!
Look at the shoes where, well, where the shoes were. Looks like a werewolf, though.
He doesn't seem happy to see us.
Wait till he gets a closer look at me.
Okay, then, we completed missing persons, apparently, and automatically went to the nameless quest.
The sisters mentioned.
Plan to bleed yourself for the goddess?
Not necessarily, but Craven did. We just might pick up his scent.
Okay then. So we need to find Craven in here somewhere. It's a bit Craven annoying this here. Quest, because it's look, intertwined with the other in Wolf's clothing quest.
To make the offering. Bloodstains, see them?
No. I may be inhumanly beautiful, but I don't have superhuman senses.
Well, you're not humble anyway.
Which is why you should stay up here. No offense, but in that undergrowth and mud, you'd be like a...
ball and chain?
Plan to say it gentler, but yeah, that's basically what I had in mind.
Fine. We'll do as you say. If the need arises, I can cast spells from up here.
I expected you to object.
Thought you might object.
Me? Please. I can be extraordinarily conciliatory.
Yeah. Emphasis on can.
What are you plotting?
Many things. How to seize the Temerian crown, how to sell Kaer Morhen out from under you. Go already.
She's a real joker, that one. But I also want to check out the In Wolf's Clothing quest. Kind of coincides here, but I'll do this as well.
Craven's blood, flowing profusely, trails clear, should lead me to him.
Okay, so there's this hole in the ground
something
here.
Something down there, can't see a thing.
And then let's follow his blood trail.
Light prints, Craven trod carefully.
And then he went down here. More footprints. And let's kill ourselves some wolves. And get ourselves some plants. So, let's continue following the footsteps. And a trail of dead bodies.
No bite marks. Mork Varg doesn't eat his victims. Strange.
Is it Craven?
No, this one's been here a while.
What?
I can't hear you. If you want to chat, come closer.
Her senses are really dulled.
We're on the trail of Morgvark himself. And it's really weird that he didn't eat this guy, since he was talking about another mortal when we were standing outside the gate.
Monster tracks. Running. Chasing something.
Okay. Can open it. And then the footsteps of Craven go that way, but I might want to check out these monster tracks first. Chasing something, and then this dead guy. And the footprints go over here. It's really confusing with the two sets of tracks. Okay. Do they go... Oh yeah, they continue over here. There's another wolf over there. So might as well fight it. There we go. More wolf's liver. So the tracks go around this little broken down well. And over this wall. Let's check it out. And then over here, there's a ladder, apparently. Cut out in the wall. And then this place.
Lots of prints, old and new. His lair must be nearby.
Looks like there's a cave. Okay.
Gotta go down, provided I can open the sluice. Mechanism looks pretty standard. One lever to choose the sluice gate, the other to work it.
Okay then. That's for the Nameless quest apparently, but... It looks... like Morgvarg's lair is in this cave, yeah.
Key? Ramond? Where's the key? All I have in the chapter house, the crate, but the key, where's the key?
That's an awfully talkative werewolf.
You thief, you rogue, you whoreson, you worthless bastard! I will find the key without you, idiot, stupid prick.
Is he talking to that chest armor with a skull on top? Oh shit.
Hide your stench.
Holy shit. So apparently my Quen shield is powerful enough to withstand two hits. Oh, there we go. We can't set him on fire. Oh, shit. So, him healing is not a good thing to happen. He's poisoned. Okay. He's down.
Only now can I slash. It's the curse. Makes me bite, scratch, mangle, till I drop. You've got time before the blood's gone from me, and I return. Listen, carefully. Undo the curse. Free me. Finally, I will reward you.
Okay, that sounds interesting. Finish Morgvarolf. That's not something we're gonna do right now. You mentioned a reward.
Mentioned a reward of some kind.
Looted. Raided. Drunk most away. All but one. True. treasure. Head away. Yours. Just help me.
Okay, stop the whining, Jesus. I'm also looking for a man named Craven.
Looking for a man named Craven. Apparently came here to kill you.
Seems it didn't work out.
Oh, aren't you a funny bastard?
Those who come rarely introduce themselves. What did he look like?
No idea.
Then I cannot help you. I've shredded Benny.
That grunting is really annoying.
So, no joy in being a werewolf?
Nay. It's the worst. Not the garden to which I'm bound, even. But the hunger. Anything I devour turns to ash. Ash I cannot eat. I cannot drink. Yet I bloody live and roam and prowl.
That does sound...
Hunger is terrible.
Really terrible. Painful.
I bite my own flesh. But the smallest morsel burns my throat like boiling tar.
Everlasting hunger, classic as curses go. Goes to explain why all those corpses went untouched.
Help, or I'll return to shred you, rip you limb from limb.
Well, that didn't work out the first time, so why would that work out the second time? See what I can do.
See what I can do.
See and do, or I shall return.
Okay, so feed. What does this do? Oh. What the? Rotting flesh. Okay then.
See if we can do this the easy way. Morkvarg, of my own free will, I offer you this fare. Now dig in.
Won't turn to ash.
Won't know until you try. Come on, a spoonful for daddy.
Fuck! This shite again!
That apparently didn't really work out, so farewell.
Farewell.
See you soon.
Okay. Get rid of the werewolf in the garden and find the key Morgvar mentioned using your Witcher senses. So that's all the werewolf stuff. And we got werewolf meat and I got my rotting flesh back. Huh. Interesting. So the key. Is the key on his thingy over here?
Friend. Patient, doesn't mouth off.
Okay then. Polymorphy. Might as well read that. The change form. To change form, to shape one's matter as clay. This is no novice's trick. No flickering glow light or rat killing blue bolt. Only those with bowels soaked in oceans of magic arcana, and few are born with bowels so absorbent, can hope to master it. There are exceptions, of course. Dragons, as is well known, possess such a talent innately. With no need for study, they can, guided by some otherworldly intuition, change between humanoid and reptilian form. As for the other races, higher vampires are known to flicker between states, yet given the understandable difficulties of conducting research in this area, We do not know if this transition constitutes an act of polymorphy. The human race is, obviously, much more accessible to scholars of polymorphy. Their years of study have borne fruit in the form of a set of methods and guidelines for the identification, nurture, and deployment of this talent. The most accomplished result of the careful application of these methods is Philippa Eilhart, which can in fact turn into an owl. And dragons can also turn into humans, as is stated in this book. And that's actually what happens in one of the stories from within the books. So we still need to find a key. What the hell is this? Is this a secret stash of some sort?
Draft from below. A cave?
Huh. Find a way into the flooded cave under Morgvar's lair. Let's try and do that. Probably by using the sluice gates outside. Hopefully he hasn't resurrected yet. How does this work? So I might as well. If I use this, then what happens? So that one opens. Now use this one. And then use this one. That's for opening the sluice gates. But now, can I use the water to go over there or not? Huh. Apparently not. Let's get back up. So there might be three sluice gates then. So let's use this one. Oh yeah, here you can see the three sticks. Okay, so now it's a third one that I can open. So now let's open this one. And now we can enter the flooded cave. And I'm gonna suppose that the werewolf can't enter here as well. So let's dive. Yeah, there we go. This is cool, actually. So there is a chest at the end here. But I do hope that Morgvar doesn't spawn here as well. Amethyst dust and a diagram for Torlund. And there's a padlock key. Unlock the chapter house doors. But I still don't really know how to get rid of the werewolf.
Fell through the crevice years ago.
Okay then. Interesting, but not really. So let's head back outside and see if we can't unlock the chapter house doors. Because we've seen a house when we were passing by. So that must be the chapter house then. Can I use this beam to get back up? Or just like that. It's also a good way to do things. So let's enter. There is blood in here, so this is probably where Morgvar killed those. There we go. Those priestesses. That's one thing. Diagram for Longclaw, Zarakanian blinders, silver ore, and butter. So let's check out those blinders. 60 horses fear level versus 20. So yeah, that's easily decided which one I should choose. So let's get back out here and open the other door. And now let's search. A sword for witches. There's a book in here. The Unsaid and NL. Morgvar's journal. Okay, that's interesting. Day 24. Tjostar the Wise has proven unworthy of his moniker. He paid me not to attack his village and then, pleased at his own cleverness, called off the watch. Never had easier work in my life. We slit the men's throats in their sleep and plowed the women till dawn. Not much loot, but primo entertainment. 2 days later, when we were sailing from Renvveig, we heard owls hooting, an ill omen, so I ordered us to turn back to shore. Puck laughed about how I'm supposed to be so brave, yet I'm afeard of the gods. I tossed him overboard with a knife between his ribs, but I could tell I'd lost a bit of respect in the lad's eyes. We'll have to do something to prove I've still got the biggest prick on board. Keep them from getting any stupid ideas. Then a week later, our visit to Hindersfjall was a success. Priestesses dead, monuments smashed, holy tomes burned, mead barrels drained. We divvied up the silver, I took the votives, Norolf's son Odlik took the basins and spoons, Mon's son of Gudvar took the candlesticks and jewelry, while Einar, son of Thoradar, forfeited his share out of fear of Freya's wrath. Fine, all the more for us. Tomorrow we'll sail to Spikerog, see what the merchant wenches have brought to market. So, Einar clearly lied about his involvement in this thing. So I'm probably gonna have to take care of that later. So, but before we're gonna continue the Wolf's Clothing quest, I do want to finish up our business over here. So let's head back to the Nameless quest. There we go. And then I'm gonna continue following Craven's footsteps after I take a little break next to lovely Yennefer over here. So, I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate the support. So I'd like to thank you all enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!